Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Nick Acosta, and I want to invite you guys to grow with me as I grow with Christ. If you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell notification button so that you can stay up to date on new videos, new content, new giveaways, new ebooks, new blogs, everything that we have going on here, okay? So today I want to talk to you guys about really quickly, okay, about the gospel of today that is supposed to work in your life and for you and I today in the same way that it worked back then in the days of the apostles. Now, I just want to start off by saying this. When Jesus came, he came to save us. When he died and resurrected, the blood and the flesh of Jesus is what was important. Why? Because we needed to be redeemed. We needed to be forgiven of our sins. We needed to be justified with God by faith in that Lamb, the Lamb of God. So just like a lamb's body or flesh and a lamb's blood was offered as a sacrifice by the priest, so was Christ's blood and flesh offered for us to be forgiven and for him to not have to die ever again, like those lambs used to have to die all the time, and those bulls and those rams and all those things in the Old Testament. He died once and for all. And he is also the high priest, and he offers that same sacrifice forever, continuously. So he doesn't die and then God has to find another priest. He stays as the high priest because he never dies. Jesus is alive forever and ever. Okay, so let's just get that covered. We needed the blood of Christ and his body to redeem us, to save us. From what? From sin, from the wages of it, from the curses that it brought, from the things that not obeying God's law it's in its entirety brought to humanity. If you read Deuteronomy 28, in that whole area, you see what happens to those who did not keep God's law completely. You see that the land was cursed. You see that their livestock, their animals were cursed. You see that their bodies were cursed. It talks about plagues. It talks about sicknesses. It talks about diseases coming on people. But it says that the blessings, right, the blessings that came upon those who kept God's law, God's word, were basically the opposite, right? So when the Bible says in Galatians and when the New Testament talks about us being redeemed of the law, redeemed by Christ, redeemed from the curse of the law, being under grace and being justified by faith and being blessed, not cursed, blessed with believing Abraham and receiving the blessings that were promised to Abraham's seed, which is the New Testament reveals what that seed is. Everybody who is in Christ. Christ was that seed, and everybody who believes in him is justified by that same faith that has works, right? Because Abraham's faith was not only faith, he actually had works to it. He was on his way. He was in the middle of sacrificing Isaac. So that was works with the faith, not just faith, but faith with works, right? So we were justified with that same faith, but not in anything other than Christ. Now that we're justified, we're redeemed from the curse of the law, and guess what happens? The gospel works in powerful, powerful ways in our lives, including our bodies, including our land, including our territory, including our children, our animals, pets, whatever. Right? Even the food that we eat. The Bible says in the New Testament that everything we eat is good, that the Lord has sanctified it, that he has made it for food for us. And as long as we thank him for it, as long as we sanctify it through prayer and the word, not nothing else that everybody keeps adding to the table, adding to the word, he said it will be sanctified for us to eat. What else did the Lord say? The Lord Jesus said, if you eat anything that has poison for some reason, you shall not be hurt. If you come across demons, you shall not be hurt. You shall not be harmed. You have power, authority, dominion over the power of the enemy, over all demons. The Bible says over all sicknesses. The Bible says that even if for some reason we have to take up a serpent, it will not harm us. So now we're talking about demons, we're talking about sicknesses, we're talking about serpents, we're talking about even poison, even venom, even you know, that poison that witches make and witch doctors make. And just think of the worst of the worst. The Bible mentions it, and Jesus said, it will not hurt us, Christians, his disciples, his followers, those who have been redeemed, okay? Why? Because when we're redeemed from the curse of the law, when we're born again into God's children, we are no longer his enemies. We are no longer in disobedience. We are now blessed. We are now redeemed, justified, forgiven. We are now his children and not enemies of God. We are now in the light, not the darkness. So guess what? No plague shall come near our dwelling. Guess what? No evil shall befall us. Guess what? We have dominion over sickness, dominion over the enemy, dominion over demons. We will not be hurt even if poison touches our tongue, even if a serpent bites us. Remember Paul, a serpent bit him. He just flung it to the fire. Nothing happened. Absolutely nothing happened to him. So this is the gospel, guys. It's powerful. It works. It's mighty. This is all scripture. This is the Bible. See, when we listen and when we read the Bible, we will get so many things that contradict what documentaries, what physicians and doctors, what nutritionists, what YouTubers, what motivational speakers, what trainers, right? Fitness trainers, all these gurus. The Bible will contradict all these people because they're not getting their teachings from the Bible. They're getting their teachings from what? From where? From trying to receive the blessings of God without repenting, without being born again, without believing in Christ and becoming followers of Jesus. They try to make themselves preserve, last longer, live longer, have less disease and sickness without actually being redeemed from the curse of the law. And that's impossible. So they try to tell you to do this, to do that, to eat this, don't eat that. And guess what? None of that will work for them because they are not blessed. They are condemned, the Bible says. They are cursed. The Bible says that Jesus came to save, to redeem, not to condemn, because those who are not born again, who do not believe in him, are already condemned. So guess what it means when you're not redeemed from the curse of the law? You are still under it. And that's what they are. So they're trying to find the best solution and ways to be healed, to live long or even forever, to be strong, to not get sick all the time, to not die early, to not see curse after curse after curse without actually believing in Christ and being justified by faith, which is absolutely something that will never happen. They will always have those things in their lives. But us, those of us in Christ, we are redeemed. We are forgiven. We are the children of God, have been redeemed from the curse of the law. So guess what? We should expect healing in our bodies. We should expect to not be hurt or harmed by anything that touches our tongues. If for some reason we're in the woods and a serpent comes across us, we should expect to not be hurt, to not have to go to the hospital. We should expect to be able to see somebody who's demon possessed and be able to cast that demon out and not be hurt by that demon. We should expect to not have nightmares, dark nightmares and demonic stuff in our home, in our minds, because we are children of God. Jesus said it, and Jesus is Lord, not these documentaries, not these DVDs, not these nutritionists, not these YouTubers and Instagrammers who most of them have no type of background, or most of them are not Christian and do not know the Bible as they should. You understand that? So when we say that McDonald's, that non-organic foods, when we say that meat, when we say that certain things that you eat will kill you, will give you sickness, then we are not believing the Bible. We are now believing people over the Bible, and that right there disqualifies you from even speaking about the word because you don't even have faith in it. So we gotta step back and remember what Jesus said. We have authority over these things, and remember what Galatians says, what Romans says. We are redeemed from the curse of the law. We are now children of God. We are forgiven. The Spirit has filled us. Listen, this body is God's temple because in the temple, the presence of God dwells, and the temple is for worship, for sacrifice, and for prayer. People are saying, oh, the temple of God, I gotta take care of it. I gotta work out 24/7 and eat carrots 24/7. When was the temple of God ever for looks, ever for muscles? The temple of God was for the presence of God, for prayer, for worship, for sacrifice. Let's remember what a true temple is. So everybody wants to claim they're taking care of the temple by eating and working out, but they're really not stewarding the temple because they're not using it for what temples are used. Temples are used to pray. Do they spend time with God? Temples are used to read the word. Temples are used to sacrifice to God, to worship to God, to join together in the name of the Lord and praise Him and worship Him. Come on. Like, the temple of God is for us to use to spend time with God. The Bible says we have access to God through Christ, through His flesh, through His blood, by the Holy Spirit. We can commune with Him. It says, pray without ceasing. That's the whole point of the temple. Not for you to be obsessed with the flesh, with carnality. A body is flesh. So regardless if you're eating burgers or you're eating celery, it's still you focusing on the flesh. And the Bible says to set your things on the mind of the Spirit, not of this world, not of the flesh. Come on. You with me, right? You guys are with me, right? So why are we so obsessed with these things and living for these things and not for God, when in fact He gave us His Spirit so that we can know Him and live for Him? Now let's go back to the eating. Can we eat this? Can we eat that? Will McDonald's hurt us? Will non-organic food hurt us? Listen, how powerful and true is your gospel? If the gospel you have been taught, the gospel that you believe in and you preach, is not the gospel that will work for you today in 2020, as it did in the days of the apostles, in the days of Jesus, it's not the true gospel. If your gospel is not going to work for somebody in the country as it will for somebody in the city, it's not the gospel. If your gospel does not work for somebody who's poor as it does to somebody who is rich, then it's not the gospel. Some people say, oh, but McDonald's wasn't given to us by God. It's not real food, so it can hurt us, because God only made real food for us. That's why it shouldn't harm us, but fake food harms us. Listen, how powerful and true and biblical is your gospel? Do you think that the gospel is meant to only bless and help those who are rich, who can afford to shop at Trader Joe's and Whole Foods and Earth Fare and all these organic food places? Do you think that the gospel is not powerful enough to help that little boy, that young girl who have a single mother who has, you know, barely has money to pay rent, so all they eat is Pop-Tarts, Kellogg's cereal, and McDonald's $1 burgers? Do you think your gospel is not strong enough, powerful enough to heal them and keep them healed because they're not rich and have enough money to buy organic stuff and eat chicken breast and turkey all day long, or just vegetables and fruit all day long? Come on, man. Let's be realistic, guys. I just want you to think and read the Bible and stop listening to people who are not in covenant with God. They don't know the power of the covenant, the new covenant. They don't know the power of the blood of Jesus. They don't know the power of being right with God, being blessed, being healed by faith, by grace, because they're not in covenant with God. And if you are a Christian and you believe like them, then you believe in somebody, something over the Bible. You're not truly following Christ. You've got to follow Christ's teachings, not only confess His name. Okay? Take that correction. You know, take that correction today. Take it like a champ. Take it like a man. You need it. Because if you believe that something will hurt you, that fear will manifest in reality and you will get sick. You will have diseases. Listen, most of the people that I know that focus so much on what they're going to eat and what they can't eat, and they got to work out this many times and do this, most of them, actually all of them, get sick all the time. All the people I know, they all get sick all the time. Why? Because their faith is not in God and the gospel and being redeemed, forgiven, born again, blessed by God. So you got to be very, very careful. The Bible says that as you think, it shall happen to you. Come on, we got to live by faith, not by sight. Oh, this looks like it has too much fat on it. By faith, not by sight. Come on, I'm not saying you should. Just overeat and indulge and just, you know, be obese or live in gluttony, because gluttony is a sin too. I'm not saying just eat all the time, but I'm also saying just believe the gospel. Believe that you are healed, you are blessed, regardless of what you eat or may not eat, and just live for God. Seek God. Listen, if you're thinking about food and working out and nutrition and what's going to get you sick all the time, you're really not following Christ, because that's not even in the Bible. You should be thinking about worshiping God, reading His word, loving, bearing good fruit. You should be thinking about evangelizing the people. Come on. If these things have your mind and your soul all day long, they're obviously not from God. It's not going to help you be sickness free. Knowing the gospel, understanding your identity in the covenant you are now in will help you be free from that sickness and disease that has got you over and over again, regardless of what you eat or not eat. Come on. Oh, but I heard this testimony, this documentary of this person who was healed from cancer because they fasted for 42 days and only ate celery and didn't eat protein, but only ate fat, and they were on this diet and that diet and this diet. What about the testimonies in the Bible? What about the testimonies of all the people who we see did not have sickness? All the people who we see got healed of Jesus' life, even himself. Like, come on, was he worried about what he was eating or not? In fact, the Pharisees were questioning why he was always eating and drinking so much and not fasting enough. And was he sick? No, absolutely not. Come on, if your gospel does not work for you today in 2020, as it did in the days of the Apostle Peter and Paul, it's not true. It's not the real gospel. If your gospel will not work for somebody in the country or somebody in the city who eats McDonald's, as it does for somebody in the country who eats fresh apples every day, it's not the true gospel. It's got to work for both groups of people. If it's real, come on, man. The blood of Jesus is still there on the mercy seat in God's temple in heaven. So what's the problem? Nothing changed. The covenant didn't change. The times changed. Maybe the food changed. The supermarket changed. But what does that have to do with the gospel? It's more powerful than all these things. If your gospel is not working for somebody who's poor, who can only afford McDonald's, as it is for somebody who eats lean steak or lean chicken breast and asparagus every day, then it's not the true gospel. It should work for both parties, both groups, just as much. You understand what I'm saying, guys? So we have to start believing God and stop believing the people, the groups, the companies that are not in covenant with God, that are not blessed by God, that have not been redeemed from the curses of the law through faith in Christ. That's you. So start believing the gospel and be free from sickness, be free from disease. And first of all, because it starts here, be free from fear. Because you're so scared, that's why all these things happen to you. Come on. You're attracting the wrong stuff that is supposed to be coming on people who are in disobedience, out of relationship, out of covenant with God. But you are in relationship. You are in covenant with God. Your faith should be attracting the power of the kingdom of God. And the Bible says that when Jesus was casting out demons and healing diseases, releasing people from sicknesses, that the kingdom of God came upon people like that by the power of the Spirit. So it's supposed to be coming in your life like that if you just start believing the word and stop being scared. So let's grow. Let's grow in believing the gospel. Let's grow in understanding the covenant that we are in. And let's grow in expecting God's goodness and God's grace and favor and healing and power. And stop expecting what is supposed to come upon fallen humanity out of covenant with God, who are in sin, who are cursed, who are already condemned and in darkness. The more we start believing God's word, the more they will see that we are healed because of Jesus' stripes. By his stripes we are healed, and not by us trying to be like them, following their diets, their cookbooks, their. No. We're supposed to be the light of the world. We're supposed to witness to them. They're supposed to see our bodies and how we're healed and say, wow, we want to serve and know that God, because he truly heals. Remember, Jehovah Rapha, he is the God who heals. Let's get back to the Bible, guys. If this blessed you, inspired you, challenged you, convicted you, cut you to the heart, pushed you, if this hurts you, good. I want you to grow with God, because when God teaches us something that we are not living in, that we're not believing, or that we're not even experiencing, then it may hurt, but it hurts to heal, to help. It doesn't hurt to harm. So let that word hurt us so that we can do something about that. Pick up your Bible today. Read the New Testament today. Get around some hungry, mighty men of God, women of God who believe God, and stop hanging around those people who are always implanting fear in you and the lack of faith in God and the gospel. Start getting in the word. Start spending time with God. Go to a church that believes in the power power of the gospel, and not just in hanging out talking about football, not just in going out outings together, and not just listening to a song, listening to a message, and just going home and still being scared of everything and still experiencing the same sicknesses that the rest of the world does. Let's believe the gospel. We have to put some work in, seek God's kingdom, his righteousness, pursue this, because he has paid the price for us. By his stripes, we have been healed. If this helped you this way, like this video, comment on this video, share this video on your social media, subscribe to this channel, share this with somebody you know, and stay hungry for what Jesus truly paid the price for us to have, because we are in covenant regardless of who's not. We are blessed and supposed to be healed regardless of who doesn't believe it. So I choose to believe the gospel. How about you? Let me know in the comments. Bless you guys. I'll see you next time.